Hi, in this lecture, I'll teach you how to work with text layers like a pro. When you want to add any text to your canvas, you have to use the Type tool from your toolbox. Its hotkey is T, and it works in two main ways. First, you can click and start typing. Photoshop will create a new layer for you automatically. This means you don't have to click on this icon at the bottom of your Layers panel each time you need a new one. When you use this method, click and start typing, you're creating what is called point text. You'll find out what that means in a second. The other method of creating a text layer is the following. You click and you drag out a box that will constrain your text to that region. I've already got something copied, so I'll paste it with Ctrl V. This is referred to as paragraph text. As you can imagine, this is better suited for large amounts of copy because you can fine-tune it through these handles. This will make it easier to position it in a design. At any point, you can swap between the two methods by right-clicking in the Layers panel. I'll do that for my point text layer. As you can see, in this list, I have the option of converting it to paragraph text. I'll hit it and I'll move back to my canvas. Now, if I click on it with the Type tool, you'll notice it's constrained to this box. If you try to add more characters, they won't show up, but you can always resize this area, so that's not a problem. Let me do the same thing for this other layer. Right-click it in the Layers panel and choose Convert to Point Text. Now those handles are gone, but you may get a warning message that says you have extra text that's outside your visible area. When you convert it to point text, Photoshop will delete it. If you're happy with that, press OK. I'll press Cancel and I'll expand it so I'll keep all my paragraphs. OK, let me do that again. Right, now those handles have gone away. You might ask, why go through all this trouble? But you'll see this is important in a lecture down the road. An important point, when you add a new text layer and you want to finish editing it, you can click anywhere on the canvas and you can move on to the next task. This only applies to CC 2017 users. For all other versions, you have to either use this check mark from the options bar or use the numerical enter. That's the enter key from the right side of your keyboard. If you use the main one, you'll just move to the next line of text. So remember, if you have the latest version, click anywhere and you're good. If not, use the check mark or the numerical enter. Most likely, this is not what you want your text to look like, though. To make any changes, I suggest you use the character panel. You could change it up from the options bar, but I find this panel much better suited for all my edits. I always have it docked here, and I like to move it underneath the paragraph panel. By default, they'll show up the other way around, so you'll have to reposition them manually. If you don't have it, just go to Windows, Character. From here, you can change just about anything you want from it. The first one is font family. Pretty straightforward, it tells you what font you're using. The default one in Photoshop is Myriad Pro. If you're not seeing what I'm seeing, go to the top right and click on this icon. From this list, choose Reset Character, and this will revert all your settings to their default values. On the right of our font family, we have our font weight. Photoshop calls it font style. Here, you can expect to find quite a few. In general, you'll have light, regular, bold, black, etc. That's why I call it font weight, but also because that's the official CSS term. Each font will have its own font styles. You may find ones that have over 10 weights, like in the case of Myriad Pro, while others will only have one. Just in case we don't have any options, you can use faux bold and faux italic. Faux is French for fake. This makes the font look like it has a bold or an italic style, but it's not something I'd recommend using. Moving on to the font size, I like to type in my values manually, and I've got used to using pixels instead of points. That's what I recommend you use as well. Points are used in the printing industry, and those who recommend you use them usually come from that background. To change your unit of measurement, hit Ctrl K to open your preferences. From here, choose Units and Rulers. In the top left, you'll find Type. Here, I have it set to pixels, as should you. OK, let's close this window. When you want to adjust your size, you have various options. You can click and use your mouse scroll. You can add Shift, and this will make the value jump by 10 pixels. You can also type in any value and hit Enter. If you go over this area, you can click and drag, and once you let go, the new value will be applied. Finally, you can also use this drop-down to choose one of these existing values. Personally, I recommend you click and use your mouse scroll. That's what I use in my day-to-day projects, and I also add Shift whenever I need to jump to a much higher value. Here's an essential notice. When you want to make any changes whatsoever, if you use my recommended method, meaning the character panel, all you have to do is have the layer selected. As you've seen so far, I can change its size, color, or just about anything without having to do anything else. Here's how some people do it, though I highly discourage it. They select the layer, but then they get the type tool and they select all their characters. Now they'll most likely use the options bar since it's always present. Don't go through all the trouble. Quickly select your layer with the control click technique and use this panel here. That's the right way of doing it. Don't waste time by highlighting all your text. Okay, next to the font size, we have leading, which is also called line height in CSS. I prefer that term because it's self-explanatory. This controls the amount of vertical space between lines of text, thus the name. It's great for improving readability, and I think it's a must when it comes down to paragraphs. Be generous with it. The auto option makes the text look cramped, and nobody wants to read something that looks like this. Anywhere from 1.5 to about 2 times the font size is a good reference. So if my text layer is set at, say, 15 pixels, my leading should be no more than 30 pixels. As you can see, this is a bit too much, but if I scale it down to something like 26, this is looking nice. Going underneath the font size, we have kerning, but that's not really interesting, so we'll skip it. It's one of those things specially reserved for type enthusiasts. I'd rather spend your precious time on things you'll actually use in your day-to-day projects. To the right of it, we have a feature called tracking, but I like to call it by its CSS name, letter spacing. And its name describes what it does very well. It controls the overall space for groups of letters or entire paragraphs. This is something that completely changes the way your text looks. It's quite easy to use, and you can clearly see its advantages when we increase tracking to 10. This increases the space between our letters, and thus it gives it a more airy feel. This improves readability and aesthetics in most cases. You can also go the other way around and squeeze the text in. Minus 20 is a good example. The results aren't dramatic, but that's exactly what we want – subtlety. This is great for a few words in a title or a headline, but for paragraphs of text, you should avoid it. You can also go to town and input some large values. It's up to you, depending on the type of effect you want to get. The other options in this panel aren't very important. It's for those users who are really into typography, so I wouldn't get intimidated by all these buttons. Let's focus on the color, which is easy to adjust. Initially, the text uses the foreground color, but with a click, you get to see the change immediately. That's it, no fuss about it. Open the Properties panel, or just make sure you have the Type tool selected for this next part. I want to mention these three options here that you already know from Word or from WordPress, or just about any text editor. This controls the alignment of your text. In general, you should keep it left aligned, but in some cases, you may want to switch it up. As you can see, the paragraph changes its alignment, and it's pretty easy to understand how this works. A real-world scenario is this. I want a nice big title in the middle of my canvas, but I don't know what font I want to use. Same thing for the size, no idea at this point. Initially, I'll type it in and I'll use the alignment tools up top to center it horizontally. But now if I change its formatting, I'll have to redo that step. Basically, each time I change my font, I'd have to recenter it on the canvas. You may think, hey, why not center it at the end when you know exactly what font you do want to use? Well, that's because you always need to make a decision in the context of your work, so it's essential I have it in the middle of my screen. Sure, here I have nothing else in the background, but imagine I had 10 other layers around it. Context matters a lot in a design. So what do you do? Well, you remove the left alignment and instead you center the text. You center it on the canvas with the tools up top. Now whatever you do, the font will remain in that position. It doesn't matter how big you make it or how diverse the font family is. That's something really useful that you can apply to all your projects that deal with text. Okay, the last thing I want to point out is this hyphenate option. That's available in the paragraph panel that's right next to the character panel. Always uncheck it, because your text will look way better without it. This is one of the things I've seen people struggle with because it's not in the character panel. They just didn't know about this setting. Besides that, you're good to go, so I'll see you in the next lecture.